So after solving example 8.4 of NCERT, we are going to look at the questions which are given on page number 103 of NCERT. And the question number 1 says that, when will you say that a body is in uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration? So let us try to understand the concept of uniform acceleration. Now, what is uniform acceleration? As we have defined, that acceleration is defined as a ratio of delta V by delta T. So I can say that if a particle experiences equal change in velocity in equal time intervals, if a particle is going through equal change in velocity in equal time intervals, then the acceleration is said to be uniform. Okay, so for example, if there is a car which is running and its velocity is increasing, its speed is increasing by 1 meter per second in every second, okay, and it is moving in a straight line, then it is said to be moving with uniform acceleration. One more thing, that acceleration is basically a vector quantity. Since acceleration is a vector quantity, so it has speed as well as acceleration is a vector quantity, so it has a magnitude as well as direction. It has a magnitude as well as the direction. So if the magnitude of acceleration and the direction of acceleration, both of them remain same, then the particle is said to have uniform acceleration. Both should remain same. Magnitude means the value of acceleration, and the direction, both of them should remain same. For example, let us consider a situation where a ball is falling freely. Okay, when the ball is falling freely, the acceleration, it experiences an acceleration which is represented by g. We are going to discuss it further in our further lectures, but I'm just introducing this concept to you. It experiences an acceleration of g, which is calculated as 10 meter per second square. Okay, now when the ball is falling under the influence of gravity, the acceleration experienced by the ball is acceleration due to gravity, and this value of acceleration due to gravity, its value of 10 meter per second square, remains same throughout the motion. Means the magnitude or the value remains same, as well as the direction of acceleration due to gravity always remains same. It is always directed in the downward direction. So that means this ball is having a uniformly accelerated motion. Okay. And after this, we can consider the concept of non-uniform acceleration. Okay. What is non-uniform acceleration? We say that if a particle is going through unequal change in velocity in equal time intervals, the particle is having a non-uniform acceleration. For example, if I am driving a car, sometimes the velocity changes by, say, like 2 meter per second in 1 second, sometimes it changes by 3 meter per second in 1 second. So the magnitude of the change in velocity is varying, sometimes 1, sometimes 2, sometimes 3, although the direction may remain same, but still, so it is called non-uniform acceleration. Or if the change in speed is same per second, but I'm changing the direction, so in that case there is a change in velocity. Okay, then if there is a, due to that, if the acceleration, direction of acceleration is changing, then it is called non-uniform acceleration. If the direction of acceleration is changing, even if its magnitude remains same, acceleration is said to be non-uniform. We'll consider in our further lectures about this non-uniform acceleration when I take on the uniform circular motion with you. Okay, there I will discuss the concept of this.